Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. I am Dr. Imran Waheed. Welcome to my channel Anatomy with Imran. Today we will talk about genetic counselling. By watching this video, you will know what is genetic counselling, who are the genetic counsellors, who needs genetic counselling, and what genetic counsellors do. Let's get started. Let's first discuss what is genetic counselling. Genetic counselling is a communication process between genetic counsellor and who seeks genetic counselling. The individual or the family member who are affected or at risk of developing genetic disorders. The genetic counselor explains the nature of the disorder, the consequences, the probability of developing the disorder among other family members, and what are the options for management open to them, and the family planning. Now, who are the genetic counselors? Genetic counselors are the professionals who have advanced training in genetics and counseling, and they work as a member of a healthcare team. And the team might consist a physician, nurse, geneticist, gynecologist, psychologist, and public health workers. The genetic counselor works as advocate for the patient, communicate with the personnel required, and helps the patient to make best decision for their genetic health. Our next question, what do you mean by consultant and proband? These are actually technical terms used in genetic counseling. Look, here is the genetic counselor. Father and mother have brought their children to genetic counselor for consultation. So all of them are consultants. But only the child is affected. The person who is first affected by genetic disorder or brings the genetic disorder to notice, he is the proband. He is also a consultant. Usually, genetic counselors take the family history starting from the proband. Our next question is, who needs genetic counseling? Pregnant women at risk of fetal abnormalities. Again, adults diagnosed with a genetic disorder or at risk need genetic counseling. Children born with multiple congenital abnormalities or chromosomal abnormalities need genetic counseling. Other than that, patients referred by doctors need genetic counseling. Now, what are the steps of genetic counseling? It has several steps we will discuss one by one. Step 1, taking of genetic family history. The patient is asked some questions by the genetic counselor. Like, what is your relation to each family member? Do you have any concern about disease or condition that seem to run on either your family or your partner's family? Has anyone ever needed treatment in hospital due to serious illness or any history of major operation? Have any adults, children or babies died? How old were they? And what was the cause of death? Have there been any miscarriage? Questions in this pattern are asked by the genetic counselors. And what is the benefit of asking this question? It reveals the pattern of inheritance. The next step is recording this genetic family history as a family tree. This family tree is known as pedigree. Before drawing the pedigree, we will be acquainted with some of the symbols. Unaffected male and female, female by circle, male by square. Joining by horizontal line, this indicates marriage. And by double line indicates consanguineous marriage. Joining by vertical line indicates the offspring. Affected individuals are shown by dark colors. Now you have to understand one thing. Heterozygotes of autosomal recessive are shown in this pattern. But carriers of X-linked recessive are shown by circle with central dot. In X-linked recessive, we know female are the carriers. And the next symbol shows deceased and spontaneous abortion. Now we will get a general idea how to draw pedigree step by step. We will start with the proband and we will see whether his or her sons or daughters are affected or not. Then we will look for his or her brother or sister and their children. We will look for the father and mother of the patient, uncle and aunt of the patient and their children, grandfather and grandmother of the patient, patient's mother and father's relatives. We will also look for the family history of the patient's partner, partner's father and mother, and also relatives of father and mother. In this way, we will check all the generations. In this way, we will try to identify the pattern of inheritance. The next step is diagnosis, and it is the most important step. To reach the diagnosis, genetic counselor needs to take accurate genetic family history, medical history, then do the physical examinations and genetic testings. By combining all this information, genetic counselor will reach into a diagnosis. The next step is the risk assessment. The pedigree is already constructed. Now, genetic counselor will analyze the pedigree, considering the diagnosis and the test results. Will identify the risks of the offspring of the patient of being affected, risk of having affected child in future pregnancy, and risk of other family members of developing the disorder. The next step is communication and discussion of options. Genetic counselor will explain the nature of the disease, and he or she will discuss the options for the treatment and the requirements of genetic testings, and also interpret the test results. The genetic counselor will also communicate with other healthcare professionals if needed, for example, doctors or psychologists. In this way, genetic counselor will help the patient to reach to a decision which is most suitable for the patient. But all the actions will be done in non-directive way. The next step is long-term contact and support. The genetic counselor will maintain long-term contact with the patient. He or she will inform the patient what to do next and support the patient in all possible way. These are all the steps followed by a genetic counselor. Now let's discuss a case. Mariam is a 48-year-old woman who has been referred to a genetic counselor because her sister was recently diagnosed with ovarian cancer at the age 45. Her father and paternal grandmother were also diagnosed with breast cancer at ages 58 and 45 respectively. Moreover, her sister has a mutation in BRCA2 gene. Now, Mariam has come to a genetic counselor. She asked some questions to the counselor. Is there any chance to develop any other cancer by me? What is BRCA2 gene? Is it preventive? What is the survival rate? Is there any treatment? What is the chance of me or my children getting ovarian or breast cancer? And what the genetic counselor will do? Obtain the medical records and relatives' test results, obtain family and medical history, analyze the pedigree, discuss features and genetics of hereditary breast and ovarian cancer, provide answer to all her queries, discuss the risks and benefits of genetic testing, review cancer risks and options for the risk reduction, arrange for testing if desired, and follow up counseling. So this was the overview what a genetic counselor do and what service a patient receives from genetic counselor. If you like the video, share it with your friends, and please don't forget to subscribe this channel. Have a nice day.